Hello, YouTube viewers. It's Cynthia Lack from Scooby Productions bringing you a new podcast on my subject called the Super Sentai Review. And like always, I'm going to speak very loudly, very clearly, and very slowly in case you don't understand me. Also, I will try to do my best not to breathe too hard during this audio podcast recording as well, not to cause any audio feedback as well. And finally, if you're under 18, this audio podcast recording will retain some adult language. So anyway, with this and everything else talking about, let's get into the latest episode of Lifting Sentai vs. Taco Ranger, episode 13. So recently, this episode started off. We see Taco Red and drinking tea at the global police in the office. Taco Green has came in the office wondering where's Taco Pink at. Turns out that Taco Red explained that, since she's been working on her day off, ever since the Gangridge Gate and the Phantom feature had appeared, that she racked up some vacation time. So basically, it was her day off. So we see Pat all dressed up nice, heading somewhere, on her day off. Anyway. Meanwhile, at the Gingrich secret dimension mansion, a new Gingrich monster named Kappa, who is like a ninja Gingrich monster, appears in front of the boss of the Gingrich gang, telling him that she has a plan to conquer the human world and whatnot. So, and basically, why she was telling the Gingrich boss her plan, she was doing said towards Goss. Goss being the main henchwoman of the Gingrich gang. So basically, it turns out that Kappa-Jow and does not like Goss. So the Gingrich boss was like, "All right, then, go ahead, then, with your plan, then." And she told Goss, "I'll show you how it's done to me." Like, and Goss was like, let's have a smart car, the Gingrich monster, Kappa-Jow, got into Goss' face and told her that I'm going to show you how it's done. And basically, Goss was like, "What the bitch, I'd like to see you try me. I'll beat your ass, bitch." So anyway, meanwhile, back at the Lifting Rangers restaurant, Lifting Red walked into the restaurant, the only one within the restaurant was Lifting Blue, and Lifting Red asked where's Lifting Yellow at. Lifting Blue responded that she took the day off to go do something, I don't know. So anyway, turns out that Lifting Yellow and Lifting Pink were heading to this amusement park to participate in a scavenger hunt into a special scavenger hunt to get a stuffed animal. So basically, it's not scavenger hunt at those amusement parks. So basically, they get you a special ticket. So So basically, you have to go on each walk. You have to go on each walk in the park, and you get your ticket stamped. So basically, Lefty Yellow and Lefty Pink were headed to the park to participate in that soon. And that stuffed animal with a scavenger hunt. So basically, when they both got there, they did not realize that they were kind of shocked to see each other at the amusement park. So anyway, so basically, thinks that maybe Patrick Paint still thinks her. And our friends are still the lifting rangers, but Patrick Pink, is worried that that she will find out about her stuff animal fetish. So basically, they did come clean about why they were here, for the scavenger hunt contest. So when they finally got to the ticket booth, turns out there was no more single tickets for the scavenger hunt. The only ticket left is a pair ticket. It's for teams for the stuff out of the scavenger hunt. So Patrick Pink and Lifting Yellow decided to work together to go on the ride to get the stuffed animal. So basically, while that was going on, Cockatoo Chow showed up at the music park, and used the power of a lifted item she had in her body case to pull up a barrier around the music park. So anyway, Cockatoo being the gamer's master who hates Goss, used the listed item in her body case to pull a barrier around the music park. So basically, when Patrick Pink and Patrick Yellow saw Cockatoo packing people inside the music park, that's when they called to the others. So basically, Patrick Pink saying, I have to go to work now. Telling Lifting Yellow, I have to go to work now to stop that gangrenous monster. So basically, that's it. Lifting Yellow took the opportunity to change into her fish outfit. She happened to have a fish outfit with her, and change and shit. So basically, Patrick Pink morphed up and battled Cockatoo, and that's when Lifting Yellow showed up, morphed up, and started to battle Cockatoo as well. So basically, during the fight, Cockatoo used her normal powers to chain Lifting Yellow and Patrick Pink together. So basically, Cockatoo used her power to chain Lifting Pink, Patrick Pink and Lifting Yellow's arm together. So basically, they were literally chained together. So basically, working together as a team, they managed to escape. They managed to escape from Cockatoo for the time being. Meanwhile, outside the music park, Pastor Red and Pastor Green showed up, and noticed that there was a barrier around the music park. So basically, they tried to So basically, Pac-Man used to try to use the power of the bite trigger to see when his physics changed the two tries to break through the barrier, but it was not strong enough. So basically, that's when Mister Red and Mister Blue showed up, used the power to bind the power of the dire father helicopter with the trigger machine biker to break through the barrier. Meanwhile, in the park, Pat the Pink and Mr. Hill was trying to break the chain that Kappa Chow used to chain their arm together. But it was no luck. So basically, they took it that Kappa Chow's side weapon is the only way for them to get their arms unchained. So basically, they decided to work together. So basically, working together as a team, they managed to not only get their arms unchained, helping Lifting Yellow to get the lifted item from Kappa Chow's body shape as well. But Pac-Man had taken a lot of damage from Kappa Chow's attack, so therefore she passed out in battle. So basically, that's when Lifting Blue and Lifting Red showed up and helped out. So basically, Lifting Red used the power of the Citrus Diaphragm Zord to destroy Kappa Chow, and that's when Pat Red and Pat Green showed up and found Pat the Pink passed out after her long battle with Kappa Chow. So basically, after getting to mansion hideout, Deathstroke told Garth to make Kappa Chow grow. Even though Garth doesn't like Kappa Chow, she did as she was told. So basically, she revived Kappa Chow and made her grow. God said, be grateful that I brought you back to life today. You should be grateful that I brought you back to life to get you a second chance to take down the lifting ranges and the pattern ranges. But Kappa Chow was acting like a little bitch. She was acting like a bitch. I didn't need your help after all. So anyway, while the Packer Rangers were tending to Pack a Pink, the Lifting Rangers used the Good Striker and formed the Lake Titan Megazord using the power of the helicopter and the Scissor Blade Zord to take down Kappa Chow once and for all. So anyway, the next day we see Lifting Yellow come back to the restaurant after from shopping and all the Packer Rangers were there for lunch and shit like that. So basically, like you know. pass the paper, we're saying sorry, but it's time to let the air out about, you know, how different her in at the Mission Park anyway. So basically, like, you know, so looking at the title is to, you know, she decides to give her the stuffed animal from the Mission Park that they want. So basically, so looking at gay have to pay the stuffed animal that they won at the Mission Park yesterday. So anyway, so basically, you know, Pat Pink was gangster for licking yellow for, you know, giving her the stuffed animal from the music park, but turns out it was the one stuffed animal. Turns out when she opened the unwrapped the stuffed animal, turns out it was not the stuffed animal she wanted. It was a teddy bear. She wanted the ugly pig stuffed animal. So basically, it turns out they were the Mission Park was giving away two stuffed animals, a bear and a pig. She wanted the pig, not the bear. So basically, like, you know, the episode ended with, you know, like, you know, in it with Patrick Pate disappointed that, you know, she didn't get the pig one, and Lester Yellow saying that, you know, I don't know what the hell is on her, but that teddy bear is better than the pig one, and this is how the episode ended. So basically, this episode was not bad. It's a pretty good, funny episode, and plus, it's a good, you know, It was a good episode between the female Wayne's as well. So anyway, this was a good episode. So anyway, like always, Cynthia Michael, sign off. 1.